This is exciting. To create a form, as you might anticipate, we need to place the code in its appropriate PSR4 directory. So, within the RSVP list module directory, create a new directory called SRC. This should sound familiar. And within the SRC directory, create another directory called form with a capital F. It is within this form directory that we will place both forms for our module. The form to collect the RSVP details, and the other form being the administrative form to control which content types will have the RSVP functionality enabled. Currently, we are creating the form to collect RSVP details. So, within the form directory, create a new file called rsvpform.php. Because RSVP is an acronym, having all the letters of RSVP capitalized, along with the F of form, is the correct use of camel case naming convention. Great work! Let's develop this. At the top of the file, place the PHP tag, of course. Then, the file doc block and the namespace. Be sure to place blank lines as appropriate. Notice how the namespace reflects the form directory of the RSVP module we are currently working in. Next, enter the lines which bring in the form functionality we need with use statements. Super! Let's build out the RSVP form class. Curly brace to complete the class. Notice that we are extending form base, the most generic base class for generating forms. Also realize that every form type actually implements form interface. That is useful to know when searching api.drupal.org for the form-related functionality. Remember the three required methods of every form? Let's build them out now. They are getFormID, buildForm, and submitForm. With the getFormID method, enter the following code, including the comments. The important takeaways here are that we are telling Drupal that this form has the ID of rsvp_list_email_form. The other takeaway here is the comment containing the @inherit_doc tag. According to Drupal coding standards, for a class, if you are overriding or implementing a method from a base class or interface, like we are, the documentation should be exactly the same as that base class or interface method. Essentially, you achieve this exactness by using the @inherit_doc comment tag. At the time of this recording, inherit_doc should be all lowercase and not typed with a capital D. Also note the curly braces around the @inherit_doc tag. This must be the only line in the doc block. Awesome work! When you are ready, let's begin to build the buildForm method. This method returns a form render array. Type the following code to begin the method. Be sure to include the closing curly brace and the doc block. If you're curious as to how we obtained the function parameter definition of buildForm, we found it on api.drupal.org by searching for the form-based class and then finding its buildForm method. Good to know. Now, let's build out the form array. When we are done, the form array will have three elements: an email text field, a submit button, and a hidden field containing the node ID. First, let's enter the email text field like so. Pause the video if you need to. Notice that the type of this element is text field. We know to use the keys we are using here because they are documented in the text field form element found on api.drupal.org. Required true means that the user must enter a value into the field before the form can be submitted. Also note that the values of the description and title keys are wrapped in the T translation function. Well done. The next form element is the submit button. You can achieve this by entering the following. The text of the button will be RSVP. the final element of this form is a hidden field containing the value of the node ID that the form is displayed on. Enter this code. Realize the type is hidden, and the value is from the variable NID, which we will define in a moment. Excellent. Now that we have created the form render array, be sure to return the variable as the final step in this build form method. Return $form. Okay, let's focus again on the hidden value of NID, that is, the node ID. One of the many benefits of tapping into Drupal's form API is utilizing all the functionality that already exists in Drupal. One handy function is called getParameter from Drupal's global routeMatch class. You can use this method to get information from the current path of the displayed page. We will use getParameter to obtain a fully loaded node object from the path and use the node object to get the ID of the node currently displayed. To acquire a fully loaded node object, enter the following code above the form variable declaration we just completed. RouteMatch getParameter attempts to find the string passed to it in the current path. In our case, it'll look in the path for the string node and its value. If it does find a match, the getParameter function returns a fully loaded entity. That's cool and convenient. So, for example, a page with a path of node/8 has a raw ID of 8, while the returned value of getParameter would be the corresponding fully loaded node object. For the hidden NID value of the form, though, we do not need the fully loaded node entity, just its ID. So let's populate the NID variable with the following code. We are using this if-else statement as a failsafe when we go to try out and test this RSVP form initially. If the getParameter function does not find the parameter passed to it in the current path, again, in our case, node, then it will return null. For instance, pages without a node parameter in its path could be custom pages, taxonomy pages, user pages, etc. However, if a node is found and loaded, then we use its ID to set the value of NID. Else, we set it to 0. Fantastic effort from you. This completes the build form method. Let's go on to the submit form method to handle form submission. Below the build form method, enter the following code to begin the submit form method. Remember to always close the method with a curly brace. At this point, we are simply going to have this method display a message letting us know the form is working. After we learn about interacting with the database, we will come back to this submit form method and update it with database functionality. For now, though, enter the following code in this submit form method. The first line here with the form state variable is important. Form state contains all the user entered values and hidden values of the form elements defined in build form. Essentially, form state is the status of the values entered into the form at the time of form submission. To access the element values, we use the getValue method. Here, we are saying, please get the user entered value of the email field and store it in a variable called submittedEmail. Remember from the build form method that the string email corresponds to the text field called email. If we wanted to get the hidden value of NID, we would use NID here. The next line displays a message letting us know the form is working, and that message will also display the email value submitted. All right, that does it. At this time, we have built the form to a stable enough state to check to see if it works. We have declared a form called RSVP form, which extends form base, and we implemented the required methods of getFormID, buildForm, and submitForm. Be sure to double check your code Save the file, because in the next video, we will build a route to the form so we can check it out. Happy learning!